Katrina Du, welcoming you to Step Into the Valley with the 3-Step Realty Group. Today, we're going to talk about how to attract the most buyers to your home through preparing your home. Now, there's 3 main steps to get the most buyers to your home when you're selling it. That's preparing the home, pricing the home, and promoting the home. And today, we're going to focus on preparing. Now, first impressions are huge, not just when you meet someone for the first time, but when that buyer drives up to your house and sees it for the first time. And the first thing that they're gonna see is the curb appeal of your home. So it's really important to make sure everything is manicured and beautiful in the front of that home. It doesn't mean go out and spend tons of money to upgrade it. It means maybe if you have lawn out there and the lawn needs a little watering to be green, get some water on it, or trim the bushes, or add some plants that aren't expensive in the front. Or if you have a low maintenance yard, then just make sure it's clean and nice for them to see. And the front door. Make the front door welcoming. Sometimes a fresh coat of paint on that front door really helps pop that home too. The next thing is declutter or simplify the home, because once that buyer steps through that door, they're gonna see what's in there. So making sure the home is simplified, meaning you don't have a whole lot of furniture in there, because maybe you have a huge family and it's important to have a lot of seats for them all in there. And sometimes having too much furniture in the home makes it feel smaller than it is. So focus on decluttering and moving some of the furniture out that you don't need, maybe into the garage. And you know what? Buyers expect the garage to be full because they know that you are moving some of the stuff out and getting ready to move. The next thing is depersonalize. Now, what I mean by that is, I'm sure if you have pictures of your family, you probably have them on the walls or somewhere, or maybe diplomas or something like that. What we recommend is taking those pictures down. I like to call them walls of love. Take that love down of your personal love, so when the buyers come in and they walk through and they see it, they can picture their family love on those walls. It's hard for a buyer to go through and see, if they see your family out there, they're not going to be able to picture their family there. Okay, another step is paint. Maybe you have a taste in paint where you prefer a home that's lime green or pink, or you like dark purples or burgundies. Well, sometimes a neutral color, changing the paint to a neutral color, will help attract more buyers. Or maybe you have a neutral color and you just need some touch-ups along the edges, because when you live in a home and you've got kids or you're walking through, you might scuff the edge. Just some touch-up. Another thing would be make some simple repairs that are in the home. So like if there's any loose handles or knobs, tighten those up. We are in a market right now where buyers want move-in ready homes. So if there's any repairs that need to be made, simple ones that you can see right away, try to go ahead and make those. Okay, now here's a big one, ready? Check for smells. So go outside, get some fresh air, and then walk into each room and check for smells. Maybe it's pet. Maybe you don't have any smells because you know what? You just cooked a wonderful meal and you've got that kind of smell in there. Or for me, I have boys, I have young boys, and in their rooms it smells like boy. So check for those smells, because you want to make sure that there are no odors that stand out to a buyer. Even the faintest odor could turn a buyer off. So also, if you're a smoker, stop smoking in the house, go outside and smoke to start freshening that up. Go outside and then paint the house, the walls. Okay, here's another one, deep clean. You want to make sure that home is clean, deep clean. So that means the baseboards are clean, the walls are clean, the appliances are clean. So that oven, the stovetop is nice and clean, the inside of the microwave's clean, the bathrooms. Okay, when I'm going around with buyers and we're looking at homes, those buyers are looking behind the toilets too to see how well it's maintained. So make sure it's deep clean and it looks well maintained. Okay, here's an important factor for you. Make sure before you have people coming into your home, you hide any valuables that you have, because unfortunately, we as realtors can't follow around our buyers everywhere they go, and we can't control what they do. So if you have particular valuables that are important to you, we recommend that you hide them or lock them away somewhere. Jewelry, because I know jewelry box on the dresser, hide them. Okay, and here's another one that's simple and easy. A lot of buyers will go into closets and open kitchen drawers. So what we recommend is that you organize and clean your closets and kitchen drawers. What I mean by that is, if you have a lot of clothes in there, like I do, for all the seasons, maybe if you're in a particular season where you don't need those clothes, take those clothes and put them in a box. Because you know what? You're moving anyways. And what it does is it'll minimize what you have in that closet and make it look bigger. Keep it organized and neat. And then of course the kitchen drawers and bathroom drawers, buyers will open those. So try to make sure that it's nice and neat in there. Because if you have every one of your drawers look like junk drawers, which I might have one or two at my house, then it can turn a buyer off because again, even though it's a drawer, it will make it look smaller than it is. So we've gone through a list of things to help you prepare your home to sell it, because those will attract the most buyers to your home and possibly get you the most offers. All right, stay tuned to other episodes of Step Into the Valley, and we look forward to giving you more info.